from Creamer Media in Johannesburg. This is the Real Economy Report. Tools maker Lasher Tools recently took media through its Wadeville factory to display its focus on producing quality tools and to highlight the jobs this sustains. Skulkberger has a story.
Lasher Tools highlighted its focus on quality and the requisite skills of its personnel to manufacture its high-quality tools. This commitment to quality products boosts the productivity of the end users and stands the company in good stead in international markets to which it exports, according to the company. Lasher urged companies, small business owners and consumers to buy good quality local products and urged government to clamp down on improperly declared imports. However, the company further advocates local manufacturing and urges the industry to ensure the local retention of human capital and economic capabilities. Lasher Tools marketing manager, Albert Lowe, provides an overview of the company and its approach to sustaining its brand.
We went from making tools only for the mining industry to today where we have three factories across South Africa making 1,200 different type of products. And the factory that you're in at the moment, Wadeville, is where we make most of our KVI lines, which is your spades, your forks, your shovel, your rakes, and your wheelbarrows. The Ladysmith factory does anything cutting, so the saws and hacksaw blades. And then we have the Germison factory, which is our iron tool factory, and they do iron tools, iron bars, hammers, and chisels, and etc. Well, because we employ over 800 people, we take that responsibility very seriously. So we carry a few stamps of approval. So one is SGS, which is international approval. We also have an ISO process within our factories to make sure that they work on a certain international standard. All our raw material is sourced locally. So Sasol and Mittal Steel being our number one provider. So Mittal gives us all our raw material. And the reason we do that is that they have uniquely been able to consistently provide us with a good raw material. And that's one of the problems with sourcing from anywhere else, is there's inconsistency in your supplies. With Mittal Steels, we know exactly what we're getting, our machines understands the raw materials, and that's why ultimately we can make the perfect equipment. That's also why we source our polypropylene part also locally, so that we have a consistency in our supply, so that the product can come out consistently in value and quality.
Other news making headlines. It makes economic and technical sense for electricity utilities such as Eskom to source as much new wind and solar photovoltaic energy as possible.
Rooftop solar installations with storage, though, are of greater benefit to all parties, as that would help reduce maximum demand in municipalities as well as the system. But given our seminar theme about flexible generation, now I also have to ask the question, so if you have a rooftop solar system but no storage, can that be considered flexible? Because I think in a lot of the stuff I've seen, PV is almost put forward as flexible. But without storage, you know, it's very difficult to say it is flexible. So the Electricity Regulation Act provides certain key objectives for the energy regulator to achieve, and one of the key ones for us is that we must achieve the efficient, effective, sustainable, and orderly development and operation of electricity supply infrastructure in South Africa.
That's Creamer Media's Real Economy Report. Join us again next week for more news and insights into South Africa's real economy. And don't forget to listen to the audio version of our Engineering News daily email newsletter.